read my paper here. Here I will start my writing my paper with the abstract, so abstract so that the essence can be understand the paper I'm going to read. So my paper is on a religious significance of Buddha footprints in the region. I am from Dr. B. R. Ambedkar University, Agra, a research scholar. These are some pictures related to the religious significance of Buddha footprints in Braj region. I think my abstract better can make understand the topic here. That the Braj region has a very ancient culture from the point of view of Buddhism history, which dates back 600 BC. Buddha, with his Sangha, traveled across northern India along with Braj region by teaching his Dhamma, teaching to the common people and showed the path to heal from all kinds of suffering. Very quickly, common mass got connected with his simple Dhamma. From the Pali Buddhist text, the world Buddhist map, we can know that because of spiritual and religious importance, among eight important Buddhist holy places, including Sankisa is one of them, in Mahatirtha, here on the route of Braj and Sankisa, Buddha with his Sangha arrived twice, once in Sankisa Sankasya, earlier in time, to teach the Abhidhamma to the people of Sankisa in the memory of his mother, and in Mathura to free the people of Mathura who stand from Yashta, Yashni, Kerala and Phobia. During the Trangvasavas, Buddha with his Sangha also stayed at Varanja, Atranji Kheda, Eta to heal and free the people from all sufferings of drought and pandemic. And to take rest, he stayed in Bulya Tatal, now in Delhi, it is Buddha Tatal, in Atmaspura, Agra too, in between Mathura and Eta district, according to Buddha, Buddhist texts and Hindu religions. As per the incidents related to Buddha, Sankara Sutra erected two paths, pillars, viharas, sangharams, etc. on this travel route, and for the future sanghas stays and meditate. Later in Samrat Kanishka reign, Braj region became the center of Buddhism and Buddhistas. This all developed the religious faith in the people of Sankisa and Braj that makes its religious significance too in present time, whether people used to gather in Sankisa for the holy 4-month Vasavas from Asar to Ashwini Purnima, that is Mahaparna Day, the day for 3 days International Religious Fest on day or they explore the footprints of Buddha from all across the world all year round. The modern rise of Buddhism motivates the local people along with other parts of the country of Buddhist faith to follow Buddha footprints in this region because of the Sankisa, keeping in mind the increase of these Buddhist activities that has taken place in the region is in the recent years, we make an attempt to throw the light on it through this article. So this is the abstract, and let's here we took some other PPT. Right. So here are some pictures which show the religious significance of Buddhism in Sankisa. Dalai Lama used to come in Sankisa. He has inaugurated the 80-foot big elephant pillar in Sankisa. So these things I already discussed here. So here the Lord Kanigam, Vasa Kanigam also exhibited here very things here, and this is 85th elephant pillar in Sankisa. There are some other monasteries in Sankisa from Japanese, Cambodian, Myanmar, Abhidhamma Buddha Vihar by Rajya Center, Sri Lanka Buddha Vihar. This is Atranji Kheda Stupa in Eta district. And it is the figure of Buddha in Katra Tila Mathura in Padmasana. So there are many tilas found in Mathura, and this is the museum of Mathura showcasing all the relics that are found in the Braj region. So it is very famous state museum of Mathura. it is Buddhiya ka Taal and not Book. That is what the Buddha ka Taal in the Vedic or in Ayurvedic papers. So here the Asoka has erected a Asoka pillar and a stupa of three story building in Ashtakoniya एक उसमें बनाया हुआ है। और यहाँ पर भी हर साल जो है एक मेला आयोजित होता है पूर्णिमा पर। ये आगरा में एक पुण्य विहार है, इसका ऐतिहासिक महत्व डॉक्टर अम्बेडकर ने इस विहार को स्थापित किया। तो ये अभी देश विदेश से लोग आगरा देख रहे हैं क्योंकि डॉक्टर अम्बेडकर ने अपने हाथों से इसको स्थापित किया। तो एक तरह से आगरा से ताल और इस सती पाठ के विहार से इस तरीके से और ये कुछ लिटरेचर रिव्यूज मैंने लिए हैं, कुछ रेफरेंसेज हैं और भी रेफरेंसेज हैं जिसको भी लिस्ट यहाँ कर सकते हैं, उसको मैंने एडिट किया है। ये डाटा कलेक्शन के बारे में तो बताया, प्राइमरी डाटा और सेकेंडरी डाटा दोनों सोर्स से हमने ये सब कोशिश की है। ऑब्जेक्टिव ये है कि हम संकिता और प्रतिदिन को आइडेंटिफाई करना एक नए रिविजन एसोसिएशन के रूप में और फिर उसके आस पास जो पोटेंशियल सेंटर्स हैं उसको खोज पाए और उसे आपके सोशल इकोनॉमिक प्रोटेक्शन क्या निकल सकता है, अल्टरनेटिव प्रोटेक्शन कैसे निकल सकता है जो कि वहाँ के लोगों को और देश की इकोनॉमी को हमारे बढ़ा सकता है। और इसके लिए हम टूरिज्म सेक्टर और गवर्नमेंट को मोटिवेट करें कि वहाँ डेवलपमेंट को लेकर जाए। इसका सिग्निफिकेंस यही है कि बहुत कुछ एक्टिवेशन है जिसे हम खोज सकते हैं। और कंक्लूजन यही है कि पीस और हार्मनी का मैसेज है टूरिज्म से जिस जो कि आज की एक जरूरत है सस्टेनेबल स्पेशल दुनिया के लिए जो डिस्टर्ब होती है दुनिया के लिए। तो उसको हम कैसे निकाल सकते हैं, क्या क्या आयाम हो सकते हैं, हम लोग इस यहाँ देख रहे हैं वही सब कंक्लूज लेकर के हम आए। थैंक यू वेरी मच। थैंक यू।